question number one is, where does the government of the People's Republic of China derive its legitimacy from? Is it directly from the party or from the people of China?
叫我先用英文回答，再用中文简单说一说。Okay, yeah. Thank you for your two questions. On the first question concerning the legitimacy of the Chinese government, let me explain this way. You know, China is indeed a unique country. I call a civilizational state, which means the combination of the world's longest continuous civilization and super large modern state. Another phrase to describe this kind of state is I call amalgamation of hundreds of states into one over its long history. In other words, China is a continuation of its own history. In the past over 2,000 years, China has been governed under what we call unified ruling entity, 统一的执政集团. What's more important behind this unified ruling entity is what we call meritocracy. China invented what's now called the civil servant examination system. So that's how this tradition has continued to this day. Then we also have the meritocracy of this whole system. I call the selection, yeah. Selection first. To be a member of the political bureau, standing committee, minimum requirement to my man, to govern at least 100 million people, but it came to this position. So it's extremely demanding, yeah. So I describe Chinese system as selection plus election. It's much more effective than the American system of relying simply on election. In my debate in Nexus Conference, I said, my goodness, you know, George W. Bush and Donald Trump are way below the Chinese bar, too low. 我刚才回答他第一个问题就是中国政府的合法性的来源。中国是一个文明型的国家，它数千年来形成自己独特的传统。今天中国还是个传承的延续，这个制度跟美国竞争一点困难都没有。
I can't tell if it's edited, bro. What the fuck? They swallowed that up? I cannot tell if that shit is edited. Alright.
Young rebels willing to die and kill for democracy. In Myanmar, a fierce guerrilla war is intensifying.